He professes to have the knowledge of God, and he called himself the child of the Lord. He was made to reprove our thoughts. He is grievous unto us, even to behold, for his life is not like any other man's. His ways are of another fashion. We are esteemed of him as counterfeits. He abstains from our ways as from filthiness. He pronounced the end of the just to be blessed, and make his boast that God is his father. Let us see if his words be true. Let us prove what shall happen in the end of him. For if the just man be the son of God, he will help him, and will deliver him from the hand of his enemies. Let us examine him with spitefulness and torture, that we may know his meekness and prove his patience. Let us condemn him with a shameful death, for by his own saying he shall be respected. Such things they did imagine, and were deceived, for their own wickedness has blinded them. As for the mysteries of God, they know them not, neither hope they were for the wages of righteousness, nor discerned a reward for blameless souls. For God created man to be immortal, and made him to be an image of his own eternity. Nevertheless, through envy of the devil came death into the world, and they that do hold of his side do find it.
Thank you. land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be bound without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell.
I'm gonna see it tonight.
Stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
They shall see him and despise him, but God shall laugh them to scorn, and they shall be hereafter a vile carcass and a reproach among the dead forevermore. For he shall rend them and cast them down headlong, that they shall be speechless. And he shall shake them from the foundation, and they shall be utterly laid waste, and be in sorrow, and their memorial shall perish. And when they cast up the accounts of their sins, they shall come with fear, and their own iniquities shall convince them to their face.